market day in the village, and the crowds were really quite dense. But what caught my eye was the store piled high with musical instruments. And up to the store came a little old man, his clothes all tattered and thin. But his face come alive when his eyeballs caught sight of a beautiful old violin. Up to the dealer, saying, "How much is this one then?" He replied, "That's a Stradivarius. That'll cost you £4.10. "I can't afford that," said the little old man. Then a lump came into my throat. I was feeling quite flush, so I stuffed in his hand a brand new 10-shilling note. A crowd had gathered behind us, so I quickly went round with his hat. When I finished, I found I'd collected £5, so I got my 10 shillings back. Well, we gave the dealer the money, and the old man, so shabbily dressed, picked up the violin, put it under his chin, and he played like a man possessed. He played concertos, cantatas and fugues and polkas and waltzes too. Composers like Johann Sebastian Bach, to mention only a few. He played waltzes by Strauss and Die Fledermaus and Tales from the Vienna Wood in Tchaikovsky's Piano Concerto. He didn't play that quite so good. Well, done by the time he finished, and they gently patted his head. But the excitement was too much for the poor little man, who unfortunately fell down dead. Well, we gave the dealer his fiddle, we took back our £4.10, and picked up the old man and laid him to rest in the cemetery down by the glen. But sometimes at night when the moon shines bright, if I should happen to stray up over the hill, it seems still I can hear the old man play. Yes, the words of that popular song ring true, for though the old man is gone, yes, although the song is ended, the melody lingers on.